Hi everyone, today we are going to see about the introduction of data structure. We are going to see in general what is data structure. Everyone know what is data. Data is just information. It is a collection of information, some information. It may be any information. It may be a number, or it may be a name, or it may be a data which is collected from the patients or from the school record, whatever it is. So it may be some information. Data means it is a information. So here the data structure, which is representing the structure or the arrangement of the data which you have. So here in data structure we are going to see the arrangement of all those data, in which way it is going to be stored. So it is a organization of data. Once you organize the data very well, then you can use it efficiently. So many types of data structures are there. I have given some examples like array, pointer structure, linked list, stack, queue. And once you have arranged the data, those data can be accessed through some way of techniques. Those techniques are called searching, sorting, and programs, files, handling, like this. So who know the programming, like if you have some idea about the programming languages, then you know what is integer, float, character, pointer and all. Here I have just classified like built-in data structure and user-defined data structure, etc. But it doesn't mean that this much only we are having the data structures. So many types of data structures are available. Just I have given for some example built-in data structure. Built-in data structure, like if you have the numbers, then you can use the integer and float. It is a data type. Integer is one type of data type. Float is another type of data type, which is used for the numbers. This both are the data types of numbers only. And character and pointer is also another type of data type. Like character is used for an alphabets. Pointer, it is a variable which will be used to represent another variable. So user defined data types is like array, list, file, so many are there. We will see elaborately in the upcoming slides and in the upcoming videos also. In this video we will see what is it. Just I will give some introduction about it. In the future video I will tell what it is, where it is used, with example, everything I will tell you. Array, in general array we will represent it as a homogeneous or collection of similar data items. Example, if you will take a student record where they have the ID of particular student, there is a unique ID, right? ID number, so, or serial number, whatever it is. So they will have their number and they will have their name also. So if you want to store the ID number, then you have to choose the data type as this integer, where you can store only the numbers, ID numbers. You cannot store their name in that. So here it is called homogeneous or similar data type. Since it is a container, in one variable you can just store multiple numbers. So you can create one variable with the array number 10, means you can just store the 10 values. If you create it with 100, then you can store 100 values. So it is like this. So here it is the example where they have created with the 10 number of array. You can store 10 values. It may be any value. It depends upon your data type. Next is stack. It is also another, just take one container where you will store some CD, or take a CD pouch, CD container. Like here also it is given like that. So if you, which disk you are keeping at the last or first, that disk will be kept in the bottom of the stack. Then one by one you will be storing it. At the end you will be keeping one disk, which will be the last disk. But the thing is, if you want to take the first disk which you have stored in the bottom, then you have to remove every disk which has been kept on it. Understand? Which means, if you want to access the data which is kept at the bottom, that is which is kept at first, that can be accessed only when you are taking out of all items which is placed on it. So this is the method of stack. So here they will be using one pointer which will locate the point of the top of the stack always. So we will see in elaborate. Then queue, this concept everyone know very well. A queue concept is very easy, like whoever is standing in the queue, it is an ordinary way. Whoever is standing in the queue, who is at the first, they will come out first. Who is at the last, they will come out at the last. The same way data will be also accessed. So another is a very good concept, tree. So tree is it is just like the organization of the data only. They have used the tree concept. If you go for a tree, the tree will have one root, and then there is a stem, then there is a branch, then sub branches, then leaves, like that. They have used the tree concept in the data structure also, but in the inverted way, inverted. So usually the root of actual tree will be under the ground, but here it is inverted. Like the root will be at the top, then there is a branches, then sub branches, then leaves. So in this way the data will be organized in the data structure. So many types of data structures are there, but once you have arranged all the data, then we have to access the data. Then there should be the way how to access the data. To access the data, there is a method called searching. So in searching also different varieties of searchings are there. So we can see it, how they will search it, and then we will see the method how all will be searched. So it is just like a basic introduction. We will see each and every topic in detail in the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.